Dear children, today we are going to see a story of Amrita. This is a true story from long, long ago, almost 300 years ago. In a village called Khejali lived Amrita. Khejali village is near Jodhpur in Rajasthan. Dear children, do you know where the state of Rajasthan is? Yes, this is Rajasthan. The village got its name because of many Khejali trees that grow there. Khejali tree wood is such that it will not be affected by insects. Its bark is used for making medicines. People cook and eat its fruits. Animals in this area eat the leaves of the Khejali. What are the uses of trees? Trees give us oxygen, habitat for many animals and birds, gives shadow, wood, fruits, medicine and rain. The people of this village took great care of the plants, trees and animals. The people of the village remembered what their elders used to tell them. They used to say, plants and animals can survive without us, but we cannot survive without them. Amrita would get up early every morning and greet her friends, the trees. She would choose a special tree for the day. She would put her arms around the tree trunk and whisper to the tree,
friend, you are strong and beautiful. You care for us. Thank you, tree. I love you very much. Give your strength to me also.
Like Amrita, the other children also had their special trees. They would play for hours in the shade of the trees. Time went by. In King's palace, the king ordered his minister to cut down trees for wood to build his palace. So that minister sent woodcutters to Khejali village for cutting trees. Amrita was now grown up. One day she went to greet her friends. She saw that there were some strangers in her village. They had access with them. They said that the king had sent them to cut trees for wood. The wood was needed for building the king's palace. Amrita was shocked. He went to the tree that the men were about to cut. She put her arms around the tree and hugged it tightly. The men shouted and threatened her, but Amrita did not let go of the tree. The king's men had to follow his order. They had to cut the tree. On seeing this, Amrita's daughters and hundreds of villagers, old and young, hugged the tree to protect them. Many people, including Amrita and her daughters, died to save the trees. When the king heard of this, he could not believe that the people gave up their life for trees. He visited the village himself. There he learned about villagers' respect for trees and animals. The villagers' strong feelings for trees affected the king greatly. He ordered that from then on, no tree would be cut and no animal would be harmed in that area. Even today, almost 300 years later, the people of this area, called Bishnois, continue to protect plants and animals. Even though in the middle of the desert, this area is green and animals roam freely without fear. So, children, we must safeguard our environment as much as possible. Is there a place near your house, school, or along the roadside where trees have been planted? Why were they planted there? Have you seen anyone taking care of the trees? Who does this? Have you seen fruits on any of the tree? Who eats these trees' fruits?